إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسل الله تعالى بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا داعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد، قال جل وعلا في كلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، صدق الله العظيم. My dear brothers and sisters and elders, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I want to remind myself and you of that most important duty that we owe to Allah Jalla wa Ala, which is to express our thanks and to make shukr for all that He has given us. The shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the beginning, the foundation of all goodness in this life wal akhirah. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala began His kalam in His name by this ayah of Surah Al-Fatiha: Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise and all thanks is to Allah, the Rabbul Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined shukr upon us and warned us about His punishment. He warned those who are ungrateful about His punishment. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. I remind myself and you that to make the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been enjoined upon us. It is fard upon us. And in Surah Ibrahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and remember when your Rabb proclaimed, if you give thanks, وَلَيْنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِدَنَّكُمْ. It is the mercy and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His bounties, Allah does not need to increase the bounties. It is only justice that He gives us a bounty and we thank Him and the matter is over. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the matter is not over. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَزِدَنَّكُمْ. If you thank me for my bounties, I will even increase those bounties. وَلَيْنْ كَفَرْتُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدِ. And for those who are ungrateful and thankless, which of course includes those who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but may Allah protect us, it would also include those believers who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but who take His bounties for granted, who complain about things and who do not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then let them be warned that my punishment is severe. So what do we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for? Let us see and let us reflect and let us remind ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drew our attention to His bounties in many, many places in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced Himself as the one who gave us the biggest bounty, and that bounty is the bounty of Hidayah. It is the bounty of His Kalam, Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced Himself with that statement, where He said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة وَالنَّخْلُ
النخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العسف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان.
One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited Surah Ar-Rahman before the Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, and the Sahaba listened to him in silence. And when he finished the recitation of the whole surah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, he said, are you not going to respond? And the Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, their adab for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was such, he said, are you not going to respond? And they said, Ya Rasulullah, what should we say? What should we say? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when I recited this surah before the jinn, every time I said, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ, they said, لَا بِشَيٍّ مِّن نِعْمَةِ رَبِّنَا نُكَذِّبُ. Every time I said, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ, which of the ni'mah of your Rabb will you deny? They said, لَا بِشَيٍّ مِّن نِعْمَةِ رَبِّنَا نُكَذِّبُ. They said, oh our Rabb, we do not deny any of your ni'mat. We thank you for our ni'mat, for the ni'mat that you have given us. My brothers and sisters and elders, I remind myself and you that we need to thank Allah Jalla wa Ala for what He has given us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us in this Quran about how ungrateful we are. He said, هو الذي أحسن كل شيء خلقه وبدأ خلق الإنسان من طين ثم جعل نسله من سلالة من ماء مهين ثم سواه ونفخ فيه من روحه وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة قليلا ما تشكرون. He is the one who created everything in a beautiful form. He created the prototype of the insan from thin, from soil, clay. And then he created the genetic process by which the human being is to be replicated and reproduced. And he gave sama wal absara wal afida. He gave him hearing, he gave him eyesight, and he gave him understanding. SubhanAllah, I remind myself and you, how many times do we actually thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically for these things? How many times have we thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, you gave me eyesight. Alhamdulillah. Ask the one who is losing his eyesight what happens. Not only did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us eyesight, He did not make us colorblind. He gave us full color vision, so we can appreciate the glory of the sunset and the sunrise. The different colors of the sunset and the sunrise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us eyesight, which not only is a matter of looking and looking at colors and so on. He gave us eyesight with understanding so that we recognize what we are seeing. We recognize signs of danger. We recognize the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We recognize something and we know whether this thing is good or bad. It's all issue of eyesight. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us hearing. What would we be if we could never hear the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We would still be Muslim. We would still read His kalam, but we never hear His kalam. SubhanAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give hearing to all those who don't have hearing. Make dua. There is no dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot do. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba asked him, Rizwanullahi alayhi wa sallam, they said, Ya Rasulullah, we make dua, but we find that sometimes these things happen and sometimes they don't happen. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are three kinds of dua. He said, one is when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something and He gives it to you. He said, the next one is When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something, and instead of giving you what you asked for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes the calamity that is due to befall you at that point in time. And he said there is a third kind of dua, where you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something. And fi bashirati Allah ta'ala, it is not in your qadr that you should get this thing at that point in time. So Allah does not give it. And also fi bashirati Allah ta'ala, at that point in time there is no calamity that is due to befall you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps with him. And he said on the day of judgment when you are produced before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you this dua. And he will say to you, O my slave, you asked me for this and I gave it to you. And you asked me for this other thing and this was the calamity that was to befall you and I removed it. And of course today we don't know what these calamities are. Allah will show us this. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, but my slave, you asked me for this thing and I did not give it to you. And at that point in time there was no calamity to befall you. Now this dua is with me. Now ask me what you want and I will give you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, having said this, he continued and he said that if you realize the value of that, then you will wish that all your life you make dua after dua after dua and none of them are accepted in this life. I ask myself, what is the value of that dua on the day of judgment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call us and say, this is a dua you asked me and I did not give you. Now ask me what you want and I will give you. What is the value of this? SubhanAllah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this the qadr of all of us, inshallah. That we are given a dua on the day of judgment which Allah will say, ask me and I will give you. So make dua for anything you want. There are no boundaries to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give us, and therefore there is no need for us to put any boundaries on what we can ask Him. In Tafsir ibn Kathir, talking about the glorifying of Allah and the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibn Kathir rahmatullah alayhi narrates a hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that in the people of the past, there was a man who glorified Allah and praised Allah in these words. And he said, رَبِّ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ كَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِجَلَالِ وَجْهِكَ وَعَظِيمِ سُلْطَانِكَ. He said, oh my Rabb, لَكَ الْحَمْدُ, all praise and all thanks to you. كَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِجَلَالِ وَجْهِكَ, in keeping with the glory and majesty of your glorious countenance. وَعَظِيمِ سُلْطَانِكَ, and in keeping with the glory and majesty of your majestic